All right, welcome back. I just again want to execute it, right button click, then go to run as, then click on testng test, and it will execute all the methods. Okay, all the methods run and test case only one, okay, and failure zero, skips zero, meaning, and we can find also green right here, test one by one method, and these are also green. If anything goes wrong, it will show red mark, okay, everything will be red. So far everything going on fine. Okay, now go to pom.xml file, then see we have selenium-java, we have testng, and we have also web driver manager, also a piece of software, and web driver manager is a class. Okay, now go back to our project. This is login functionality. Okay, and I think this one is our, okay, this one is our test login functionality. Now we are going to open browser here. Okay, so I'll just comment it, and first we have to invoke the browser. Okay, invoke the browser. We can put here a note. I can say this is a test case we are going to execute or convert into this test case. We are going to convert into test script. Okay, say for example this is test case one. Okay, and this test case does have step one. Okay, and this is invoke the browser. Invoke means open the browser. You can say or open the browser. Okay, first we have to open any browser. It can be Google Chrome, it can be Safari, it can be Edge, it can be Firefox. Okay, and step two, this test case can have more than one test step. Okay, so we call it steps, test steps. So test case is combination of multiple test steps. Okay, then navigate to https://. The application we are going to test is facebook.com. Okay, then step three is enter correct username. It can be email or username. Then step four is enter correct passwords. Okay, and step five is click on login button. And final step is close the browser. Okay, we are taking only these simple steps today. And later on, we will see how we can test, how we can handle multiple test cases. All right? Are you following me? Ignatius, are you there? Yes, you are muted. Are you following me?
You want to? Yeah.
Okay. Now this is our test case. Okay. It will be provided.
You have to unmute me. Hello?
Yeah. I mute you. Okay. And now we have to write test scripts using Selenium with Java. Okay. How? First, we have to create driver object from WebDriver. WebDriver is a class, okay? WebDriver is a class, and from WebDriver class, we are creating new object, and driver is reference variable. Do you remember in Java, we create object? And this new is keyword, and Chrome driver is Google Chrome driver that we are going to use to test the web application. Now, there is red mark, just hover over here. Hover over means just move your cursor, then you will find it's saying import web driver. Okay, so and when you hover over it, it will show you actually, it will tell you to import it. You see, I just click here and it has been imported into our project web driver. And the same way we will import also Chrome driver. Just hover over here, hover over meaning move your mouse a little bit and Chrome driver has been imported. Okay, fantastic. Now, you know, this is new object and this Chrome driver object has been created from web driver. Now WebDriver is parent class and this is child class. If you have confusion, because we are not creating this object from this class, we are creating from driver class. If you have confusion, even you can just say Chrome driver. And from Chrome driver is a class. From Chrome driver class, we are creating new Chrome driver class, sorry, object. So object, and this is the reference variable to this new object. But in software development and testing industry, we call this reference variable that is referring to the object. We call it also driver object because this is this new Chrome driver object is inside driver reference variable because it is variable, right? Okay. Now, this driver object, again, this is not an object referring to the new object, but we call it driver object as in the industry. everyone understands it as driver object, okay? Now, we created new object and using the reference variable to the new object, reference variable is driver. Again, it can be anything. If you just name it in place of driver, if you write your name, even it will work. But you have to use driver because everyone in your project will be using it as driver, okay? So when you just put dots, you see, now you can find a lot of properties and also methods, okay? Methods inside it because we create object so that we can use the reference variable of the new object, and using the reference variable or driver object, then dot operator, we can access all the methods and properties we have in Selenium. Understand? Now, just we will use the inbuilt methods that is already here as we require in the project. You can choose like get string URL. I'm choosing get string URL, meaning I'm telling the driver, hey driver, go and get this URL or application that I want to test. That is facebook.com. All right. And we know why there is a red mark. Why? Can you tell me why? Why there is red mark? Please unmute before you speak. Why red mark?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Okay. Yes, I can.
Red mark shows that. Yeah, red mark shows that, you know, that something is not right. Either we're missing something or we didn't.
Yeah. What is missing? Since Selenium is driving with Java,
I think we're
Selenium with Java.
Yeah, we're missing a. Yeah. We're missing a semicolon.
Semicolon, perfect. Okay, we are missing semicolon. Okay, now error mark gone. Because in Java, after every line of code, you have to terminate the program. Okay,
yeah.
With a semicolon. Some pronounce it semicolon, okay. Now, just right button, click run as application. You see, we already completed two steps. One is invoking the browser. You see, started successfully here. You see, started successfully. Chrome driver was started successfully and it navigates to facebook.com. It opens browser, then navigate to facebook.com. It opens the application we are going to test, okay? But you see, this window, we call it browser window, is half open, maybe 60%, okay? But 40% is not covered. So, and this is not closed. I'm closing it manually. When I'm closing it manually and writing all this email address password by myself and click on login button, we call it manual testing. But when we are writing code and the code or scripts or programs are executing the test steps automatically, we call it automation. All right? So okay. I am closing it manually. Okay? And the console window, I close. Okay? Now, I'm telling the driver, hey, driver. I'm telling driver, hey, driver, manage my window. I just say manage is inbuilt or built-in method in Selenium. Now window will asking me, what do you want me to manage? I'll say, manage the window. Okay, I choose window. Then driver will ask me, how you want me to manage? I'll say, maximize, just maximize it. Okay, now right button click, go to test and the test and click on okay. Invoking the browser, navigating to facebook.com and maximize the window. Clear? Does it make sense? Okay. Now I closing this browser window myself. Now, this time I'm not closing it by myself. I am telling the driver, okay? I'm telling the driver, hey driver, close the window. But I can't see close method here. Why? Because every method has its scope. Scope starts here and ends here. And this test login feature method also. What's going on? Method also starts here and close here. Same with setup method also starts here and close here, the scope of the method. Now, if you put within method, this driver, it cannot cover all the methods. It only cover this method. If you want to cover this driver functioning to other methods, then you have to define it, okay? You have to take it globally. We say global, meaning you have to go to class level. After class, you have to set it up, okay? Now, when you just copy and paste it here, Chrome driver, reference variable driver, is this driver is now functioning everywhere in different methods, inside different methods. Now, still it will not work because when you copy and paste here, Chrome driver, what you have to? You have to remove the web driver class or Chrome driver class from here. Just remove it. Now see, it has been connected to each other. The driver is connected to each of the driver. You see, it is also connected now. Mm-hmm. If you just put dot operator, now you can see close method. You see, double click, close method is there. And you can say also driver dot quit, meaning you close the driver or web application, or sorry, the web browser, and quit meaning complete the test, okay? End the session, close the session. Now, just right button click. This time you will find web driver is opening the browser, opening the browser, navigating to the facebook.com, and also close the window. Okay, it closed the window. If you have confusion, let me close everything and check again. When I'll run, there is no browser after this Eclipse IDE. Look very carefully. It will quickly navigate to the browser, opens the browser here, you see, and it will close automatically. You see, it closed. Okay, fantastic. Now we are writing the tests, a real test steps. This three is a real test. We already complete invoking the browser, navigating to facebook.com, then close the browser. Now we are going to test, okay? Now, I want not to close after method, okay? To do it, I'll just say enables equal to false, meaning enable meaning run this method, and false mean don't run, okay? I'm telling the web driver not to run this method, so it will skip, okay? Now look, right button click on test ng test, click on okay, invoking the browser, navigating to facebook.com, and Facebook didn't get closed because we skip the after method, teardown method. Okay, we say skip it, don't close it. All right, we did it because we want to find out the web elements. Now, if you click anywhere within this page, web page, and click on view page source, it will show us all the programming languages used to create this web application, okay? You can also click on inspect, and it will show here, okay? Show here all the web elements. These are web elements, okay? That is used to create this login functionality. Now, login functionality is a feature, you see? Login functionality up to here. Okay, is one feature here. Feature, and forgot password is another feature. Feature number two here. And create account is another feature. Feature number three, okay? My handwriting is bad, sorry, pardon me. So there are three different features in software testing industry and software development industry. We call this feature when we test separately, we call it unit testing, okay? We call it unit testing. Unit. This is one unit, and this is another unit, and this is another unit. When you are testing separately, you call it unit testing. So if you test separately, it will be called unit testing. When you integrate these two units, okay, and test together, it will be called integration. You are integrating, then testing together two features or two units. This is called integration testing, okay? Usually developers do it. Even you can test unit by unit and you can test together and it will be unit testing. When you test all the features together, we call it end-to-end testing, okay? We call it E2E, meaning end-to-end testing. And this end-to-end testing also called system testing. System means complete software testing. We are testing this whole software, three pieces of software together from beginning to end. Does it make sense?
Love this. Yeah, it does.
Okay, okay, fantastic. Mm-hmm. So once you understand this concept, you actually able to test it manually. How we test manually? Yeah. We open the browser, then navigate to facebook.com. Then I just say here, username is Cure Automation Job News at the rate gmail.com, and password is say for example admin 123. Okay, and just click on login. Now what do you expect if we put if we enter correct username, that is our Gmail, and correct password, then click on login button? What are you expecting?
We're expecting a full result.
Yeah, we are expecting user can log in, right? User should be able to log in. Okay, and actual result will results when you click here. What happens if you can log in and expected result is user should be able to log in, and actual result is user able, user can log in, meaning this expected result and actual result matches. When actual and expected result matches, the test is passed, meaning the software has been developed properly by the software developers or software engineers. Okay, if expected results and actual result doesn't match, if result mismatch, mismatch.
Yeah.
Then test result
the test will fail.
Fail. When it is fail, we have to tell our lead that there is a bug. We call it bug or defects. Defect. Our duty or responsibility is find the bugs and defects, as many as possible, and prepare a report, and also report the bug. We call it bug report. We will report it, okay? And we will report with a software that is called Jira, okay? Jira is a software where we can report our bug or defects and also track them, okay? We will learn it later. Now, let's focus on the concept, all these concepts, and also write the test script and complete the framework, okay? We are now doing unit testing, actually, using TestNG framework. Then we will also see how we can do unit testing and integration testing, as well as end-to-end testing, okay? Now, more than 60% or 70% companies are using TestNG framework only. So it is very important. After you learn TestNG, you can actually land a job, okay? So it is very important. So you have to practice at least 3 to 5 times to understand the concepts very clearly. You have to practice, watch the video, recorded class again and over again and practice, okay? Now we are going to write the script, okay? Before writing the script, let me talk about little more about concept, okay? Let me keep here some notes. In Selenium, there are 8 locators. What are locators? Locators help us to find web elements, locate them, and pass the parameters. Okay, what does passing the parameters mean? Passing the parameter meaning, if you go to Facebook, say for example, if you go to facebook.com here, if you can write this queue automation job news at the gmail.com with automation script, we call it passing the parameter and passing the password. We are not typing, but Selenium as a tool, the web driver is doing it for us automatically. We are writing the script, but our test automation script is working for us. So look very carefully and try to understand. I say there are 8 locators, and these locators are, one is ID, and ID is unique. ID is unique. It is unique, so I prefer ID, because if the web element is unique, it works better. Then we have also name, okay? Name, we can find it by name. I'm writing in capital cap. Then we have also XPath, okay? It is actually part of the elements, okay? We will learn very details later on, okay? Then we have CSS selectors. I think I already showed you what is HTML and what is CSS, right? HTML, create the web page. Just create the layout. And CSS colors it, make it more beautiful.
Style.
Okay. Yeah, style.
Yeah.
You remember? And we have also tag name. Tag name. Tag name is every tag of the elements. Okay. Then number 6 is class. Class or class name. Okay. And 7 is link text. Okay. And number 8 is partial link text. Okay. There are 8 locators in Selenium by which we can find the web element we are looking for. Okay, to test the web application, and we can locate the elements, and we can pass the parameter. Actually, we are 3 core steps we are taking action in Selenium, 3 core steps, or we can say actions. What are these? One is finding elements by, you can say by class, by locators. Okay. Number 2 is we are finding and locating. We copy and paste the value for the locators, locating elements. And finally, we pass the parameters. Okay. Now you can also tell you take another action, and that is click. Okay, you click also. This is also action. This is method. Okay, usually you can say 3 or 4 just to remember. Okay, so that you can remember. And we do the practical in the last session. Okay.